record these things and I know that I'm never going to use both perspectives, but I also know that in a real position, in a real studio, you should probably have them, like, completely vanilla, unedited. That's Amina. Say hi, Amina.
Hi, Amina.
What? Who's with you? Who's with you? Send her here. I'm in a meeting.
Something about babies.
I have a baby? What? I'm in the fucking water.
So?
What do you mean to do? She just randomly... Amina has to deal with the fact that, I don't know, that she went from me to my friend. The guy said, oh, I want to try to get Tia back, and she went and started dating my friend Rocco. Now she wants to help Fredley. I'm kind of like, I don't know, you fucking Rocco.
Wait, what? Were you guys dating?
We weren't dating.
I met her at the Subaru race like 2 or 3 years ago, and I didn't know if she said hi, and then my friend, I said, oh, she's cute, and then, like, later he handed me, like, oh, here's her number. He didn't even tell her.
That's fucked up.
Or maybe he said something, I don't know, but, and then I, like, texted her later that night. That was funny, because, like, within an hour of texting her, I'm pretty sure we were having some kind of, like, phone sex. Mm-hmm. Like that. And she didn't even, from what she said, she didn't never masturbated before that.
Before that conversation?
Well, it was actually, she got excited, but she didn't do anything about it. She had came over the next day, and she couldn't do anything about it. But then later, I guess, I think that I helped her to say, fuck it, and try. She's like from Somalia, ended up in Kenya, her mother died, she's in a refugee camp, like, rough shit. Probably didn't have a lot of time to... Refugee camps, that's probably pretty weird. Like, you're like, okay, I got this idea for a sitcom. There's these kids, and they're in a refugee camp, and they're constantly trying to find places to match with it. I got caught once.
Yeah?
You never been caught, right?
Not...
I mean, like, caught.
Oh, like someone walking in on you and seeing you? No.
But you did act like there was some kind of semi-catching.
Yeah.
What happened?
I was in the bathroom, and my mom was like, hey, what are you doing in there? Because she was like trying to come in, and I was like, oh, I'm in here, and she was like, oh, okay, and she was like, what are you doing? And I was like, oh, I'm washing my feet in the tub.
Did you call it?
Yeah.
She didn't really get caught, she just, you assumed that she knew?
No, I just almost got caught.
Oh.
If it weren't for the fact that I'm so good at lying.
You said you were in the bathroom. What are you doing around? Oh, no, not...
Why is
the sun still on?
Who's that?
It's in your eyes. It's in your eyes anyway. Where do you think all this light comes from? If it's not directly. Don't make that face. Let's shave your head. Still kind of look like a kid, you know that. Sometimes you'll get adult, but a lot of times you don't.
Yeah. Well, especially when I'm dressed like this. I'm dressed like a little boy right now. I'm a little boy.
I was going to say you did look like a little boy.
Yeah.
far enough away that this is just basically me talking to myself. You never tell me stories, am I just I don't know. I had another girl tell me I should write erotica.
Oh yeah? Did you prompt her to say that?
Yep. I saw a picture on OkCupid and I made kind of a comment. She was kind of like, you're funny. And I was like, yeah, it's funny, but it's also like pretty sexual in an underlying way. And she was like, lol. And then I kind of like needed something, you know, I could distract my mind. I'm not like, you said you don't think about anything, right?
Yeah.
You just meditate. I don't do that. So I saw a picture and I mean, it's pretty much like OkCupid is my porn.
Yeah.
You know how fucked up that is? It feels like wrong to be looking at real women. But like I assume none of them are gonna be like for me anyways. So it's so wrong. Why do I say these things?
Oh, it's
like grandkids like watch these videos someday and they're like, oh god. Grandpa. Great, great. Not great, Grandpa. Let's see, what's happening? Stop it! So, I have real for you.
Yeah, real story.
Real stories. Well, it all started on the 4th of July, right?
Mm-hmm.
What actually happened? My parents were on, they were in the tiniest town in Pennsylvania. What's smaller than a town?
Really?
Really?
I'm not sure. Hamlet?
I thought Hamlet. Oh, that's just when I was conceived. That's when the story starts.
Okay.
My mom and my dad are a little old school. And when you're old school, you only have sex on holidays and when you're trying to conceive.
Okay.
So, my mom had a couple of miscarriages before me, and the first holiday that arose after she was psychologically and emotionally better was the 4th of July in 1917. It was actually on the same day that Eddie Murphy got into a car accident with his grandpa and hit his throat. And that's when he got his distinctive, like, he didn't have that before. He was also born on my birthday, years before me. And my dad was born on my birthday 5 years before his father fell through a hole, a stairwell hole that didn't have stairs in it yet, in the Dunkirk coal power plant. It said it was an accident, but I actually know that he was a lot like me, and he wouldn't stop talking, and one of his co-workers literally just pushed him through the hole, assuming that he would be hurt severely enough that he wouldn't tell, or he couldn't tell. 5 days later, he died.
Really?
Yeah.
That killed him?
Falling 25 feet under your head?
Yeah.
Jackknife through your head on his head and his neck completely. Yeah, they kept him alive for 5 days. So, he was apparently a really good guy. Because back then, working in a coal power plant didn't make you like a scumbag West Virginia hick. Kind of a vision of like a world where unions were so powerful that like nobody could do anything without them. And like if you wanted something to do with coal, you had to like get it from the headquarters of the union in West Virginia, and they actually had to come to you. You couldn't have both, like, you're shuttling union workers around the country because of the limitations inherent to over-unionization. So it goes back a while, and I don't know, but my grandma ended up marrying a man named Dick Tanner. And there was definitely one time in my life when I both had used self-tanner to do my head, and then probably thought, like, I'm going to unload my gun before I go to the bar. And I may have actually tried to tan my penis once. I don't think I did, but I think I probably did. It's kind of like a combination of astro, like astro tan.
Right.
It doesn't get darker the more you pull. So he went to World War II, and I think he never told me if he killed anyone. He was like, it was an inappropriate question. And I don't know
that
if that's
because, yes.
Or it means no, and he really wanted to, but he didn't actually contribute to the death of any German.
No,
it probably means no. But it's an inappropriate question, like he didn't want to tell me if he killed me. What could be? Yes. But you said it means yes or no?
Yes.
Oh, probably good. He was kind of like at the end of the bulge. I'm not making a sex work, this has nothing to do with the Olympics or Speedos, but the Battle of the Bulge. So there was this battle, and there was an aphrodisiac factory that got hit by a fuel air bomb. And so you had this aerosolized aphrodisiac, so everyone on both sides hard as fuck. It was a brutal, brutal battle. Like, everyone was walking slowly.
Right. Epic sword fight.
Apparently, my grandfather, a bullet, he has a scar on the bottom of his scrotum.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, he was so hard that his balls, like, pulled right up, in, like, his balls, and they, like,
right.
Pulled right up inside of his body. And his balls would have been shot off if it wasn't for the destruction of the aphrodisiac factory.
Right.
But he isn't my real grandpa anyway. So it's like dead end in a choose your own adventure and get fucked up. Like, what happened? What do I hear? I'm gonna go this way. I really like that though. Like, you know, Facebook started with Hot or Not.
What?
Facebook started with Hot or Not.
What's that?
Zuckerberg hacked into the Harvard, like, student, like, files with their photos and randomly brought them up onto a page on a browser, and you could pick which one you liked more. It was like Hot or Not, but he was comparing two women who's hotter.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you in that?
No. That's real.
That's
he did
right.
That. And then he got a proposal from the Winklevosses or whatever, and he said, I'm even darker than you, and, well, they weren't darky, they were actually cool. And he, like, took a lot of aspects of their idea and built it. And used the exclusivity of Harvard and psychologically fucking with people to turn it into, like, the largest socially connected network in the world, coming from a fucking loser who wanted to be cool. And it's not a bad way to become cool. I mean, a lot of people still think he's a total fucking douche. But he also has
most of the people, like probably 58,000 people in the world, if he called them up and said, come spend a week with me, they'd probably just go. Said, is it free? And Abraham says, is it hot? I'm like, Abraham, you already fucking drank it. Not answering that question again. Is it hot? Like, ask first. He's like, is it hot? Like, nothing. Nothing, Abraham, nothing. So the kid's lawyer, I told Tia, I'm like, I think she really likes the kid. She met him one time before, and she went for a half hour yesterday, and she, like, was very effusive. Oh, yeah. His name is Mindy. The kids had their own lawyer in family court.
Oh, I see.
And she was really, like, very ebullient. Mm-hmm. Effusive. Ebullient. I used effusive 4 times today, including this reference in it. Okay. I think it's okay. Refusive. Not as good. It's like you're being effusive, but with shit.
Does that mean, like, monkeys are
allowed to refuse? Yeah. Yeah. Stop being refusive, Maramb. Haram. Is that his name? Haram? The gorilla that was shot?
Oh.
H-A-R-A-M-B-E. She really talked very, very highly of them. Like, I can't imagine every family that she talked to. Partially, I think it's me and T were actually sitting there kind of getting along at the moment. If it was two really, really estranged people, it might not happen. But she, I think she has a baby, maybe 2-year-old. And I think she, like, looks at us and, like, wishes, as a person, that, you know, she sees us kind of get along at times. And she, you know, to say really nice things that are true, that be willing to express it, you know, and make us feel good about truths of our children. Like, they're very smart. She's like, remember the last time Abraham was, like, hiding in the corner, and now he's, like, so confident, and he's a funny dude. I really wish that somehow we lived in a world where everybody had an automatic filter, like a chip put in their eye, and he could run around just naked, and nobody could actually see his penis, or even, like, just what, he just didn't think about it, you know? Until the first time he actually busted a nut, at which case he'd have to wear pants. Like, 2 things. 1, you need to sign the Constitution. 2, your genitals are invisible until you have your first orgasm. Accidents don't count. Step counts.
What does?
Step. For incest. It was her episode.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Step counts. They're like, wait. You know, like, what was the doctor? Uncle that he accused of being, and then he was at the Vagina Monologues, and the lady was like, get out, you piece of fucking shit, you coward. Is it osteopath, maybe?
I don't watch a lot of
TV. I don't think I can watch anymore right now.
Yeah.
But I did the whole of Arrested Development, I did playing the video game. But I went through the whole fucking... And again, I want to do it again. I want to watch it. People will say I'm doing nothing, but I need to make, like, when you're trying to sell people on giant fucking ideas, like, you need to give them an incentive to, you need to give it gravity so that it'll, you know, that it'll pull them in. And if you don't, if there's no smiling, you know, if there's no humor, it's very hard. So sometimes, like, watching a show for a third or fourth time with a fucking notepad, I'm not asking you to pay for it, but in the end, I might say if I complete something proper and effective and successful, it might have something to do with some of the best things that I ever watched from some of the, like, at least productive creative minds that are out there. I have thought a decent amount about maybe the possibility of trying to set up a semi-scripted show. Like, I've gone to bed a few times and tried to, like, look back on my life and look at some of the Arrested Development stuff and some of the Curb stuff where, like, you see him doing a lot of normal things and then they bring his weird opinion of it into it. And I just think about, like, what do I look like? Because I think that sometimes I'll be doing something and I just think, I know everyone doesn't do this. Like, some people do this, but this is not, like, a normal, I'm not doing it the way it's done. And sometimes that can be interesting for other people to see, especially if they like your character, like, what the fuck are you doing? Like, I don't do that. Like, why does he do that? And hopefully, like, laugh, like, that's funny. So I kind of thought, like, I was really thinking about this a lot. Part of it was drone nuts, which was the idea of the donut delivery drones that look like donuts. But then it was also maybe an idea for a show, which was called Drone Nuts, but two words. And it was kind of like, I'm nuts, and there's a drone. It also happens to deliver donuts, but it's kind of like incidental. It's like the drone, it's a delivery drone nut that's asked to like hang out when there's no delivery, so it just finds a tree. It's lighter than air, so it just finds a tree and grabs on. And it happens to become addicted to me. Like, it tries to, like, when it takes a break, it goes off course a little bit and finds more work and watch and listen to me, like, to our conversation. Like, it would be out there. So the character ends up being filmed by a delivery robot that's happened to require some kind of basic consciousness and sentience and curiosity. Did I forget that? What?
Can
I know how? I just can't.
Would you be interested in learning?
Yeah. I mean, I'm more interested in finding artists and working with...
Wait.
You want to go see them? If they came this way, were you going to see them? Looks just like what? Do you have your dog?
Yeah.
What kind are they?
Lhasa Apso.
Lhasa?
Yeah.
Apso?
Yeah. Okay, stop drinking it.
Is that like Amstel Aqua? Is that a combination of two words?
Yeah. Get out of it.
Is that like hybrid or?
Yeah.
Wait. Oh, hybrid? Hybrid.
Stop.
Hybrid would basically be like a GHC infused. She loves your dog.
Oh, awesome.
She has a dog. She thought they were Lhasas. Water pretty nasty.
Yeah, like my voice, I'm like drink it, but he doesn't want it.
Yeah, just kind of goes in on his own.
Right.
Is he able to sit in it?
No, he walks.
I mean, for me, is this okay?
I mean, I wash your feet when you go home.
Yeah.
I don't know. I've seen minnows flying around, but the green
really?
Is algae for sure.
Right.
I guess they should use it as like an algae farm. We said they need a
big
one.
Yeah, I mean, some algae is good, right?
Can feed certain species like very efficiently.
But, I don't like to drink it, he does, I don't like it.
Yeah.
And I've been coming over here for years, and he's fine, but. Yeah. He's not always shot, so it's not like he's not vaccinated.
Right.
So. Yeah, he likes it because it cools him down.
Me too.
Yeah. Only him.
She's like cleaner looking, just one color.
Yeah, she's Miss Princess. Jake, get out of here. Stop that. Come on.
Have you ever heard of a princess pool?
What's that?
A princess pool?
Yeah, what is that?
Princess pool? Princess? But it's like, it's a prince and he has a cesspool of like princesses. Princess pool? It's like a pool full of princesses. It's a cesspool of a prince. It's a princess pool. It's like he's the big prince, you know? I think we should make a story about princes and princesses that shows them, like, how they really... And not just, like, the evil stepchild. It's like, show what Frozen's really like. And that's and the song is supposed to be let it snow, and it's let it go.
What do you mean?
What about... Do you like a snowmobile? I mean, a no-mobile? How about a snowmobile? Mobile that snows. Or it's a mobile made of snow. It's like that guy who, the one guy in the world who actually said, hey, it's cold outside in the wintertime, I'm gonna cut a hole in the side of my house and run a fan through a tube to my fridge. What is the average number of years it takes to pay that off with the savings of electricity?
Like one.
Oh. They don't use a lot, do they?
Fridge?
They use a lot?
Oh, tons, yeah.
Would you ever have like a, would it be more efficient if you only use your fridge twice a day to drop it into the ground after every use? They're pretty well insulated, right? It just, you just can't completely.
Right.
You like upbirds?
What's that?
They're not birds. They're not birds that go up. Like they just, they're birds and they're born and their life cycle exists of flying higher and higher and higher until they go into space and they die of suffocation. It's like, it seems like there are species that have weird life cycles like that.
Yeah.
What do you exist to do?
Right.
Why? Like, to fuck. We exist to fuck. The other thing that keeps coming back is me as a character of perpetual and spectacular failure. Like, where I set myself up for total deprecation and I'm able to present myself as someone like, they're like, you know, if you fail, just try again and try again. But he never, ever succeeds. Like, it's completely against the whole concept. Like, don't do it. Just give up after one try. Or like three times. And then he'll get a whole bunch of shots.
Do you go to a drawing class?
I mean, there are.
Worldwide.
Why are you gonna go to?
No. Nope.
Just sending me?
Yeah.
What are you doing? You just listen?
Listen to what? Yeah. Right now? Yeah.
No, I mean like in the future of democracy, you're just gonna. I think you might be smart enough in the deep down, you're like, I'm just gonna kinda like chill out and help Alex and listen to him and laugh at stuff that's funny. And then he'll appreciate me enough that when I want my laundromat empire.
Yep, that's what I'm doing. I'm just laying the groundwork
on my laundry. Anyway, I think that you should write a comic book because I think that would be the best format for everything. But like in a comic book, sometimes the frame can be a whole page, right? It's just that if a frame is not full page, then you mix it with other small frames.
Yeah, you can format it however you want.
You don't think the pop-up, see, if I had like a couple completely free, like, but slave geniuses, like mentally free, but locked in my basement,
okay.
I think that we could literally build a globe, not a comic book, but with a pop-up book inside of it, and like literally every page when you opened it would, something like an idea would pop the fuck right out of the page.
One thing that I
like working with an illustrator?
Nope. I mean, you can work with someone else who illustrates too, but I think you need to be the illustrator because the way you think is pretty abstract, and so, but you don't have an abstract format to express that. You just have words. Everyone else who does what you do but funnels it into something else that's not words is called an artist, and it's
O-U-R-T-I-S-T?
Like accepted by society as just that, and they're like, oh, they can't have an oh, they just have like all these abstract ideas because they're an artist. Like, or oh, they live outside of society because they're an artist. You can get away with fucking anything if you're an artist.
You can fuck anything if you're an artist.
Yeah. But because the the way that you express yourself is not like poetry or like music or like visual art or like dance or like whatever, and because it's conversational like speaking, it's not, you don't get all of those free passes. And so as long as you just funnel it into another medium that's more abstract than conversation, you'll get all those free passes and be considered like, and
but I can call myself an O-U-R-T-I-S-T. Like, I hate artists. I hate artistry, but I like artistry.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Our country, tis-tree. Our country, artistry.
And anyway, I think, like, sometimes when you describe an idea, it's hard to visualize it anyway for other people, and so if you could just draw it, that would actually be really, really helpful. And I think it would, like...
Any kind of drawing. Like, I mean, I could combine... simplistic cartoony with like eventually learn some computer design. So maybe like what I want to do is publish, if I did that, would be to publish a series of comics. And yes, you got to do the first one first. I mean, you can actually work on three at a time, right? Like, I'm not finished with one, I got some ideas, I'm gonna work on three. One will finish.
Yeah, you can
three.
Publish them all at once.
I mean, just work, you know, even if one, like, you might have half of episode three done when you finish one, you know, like concurrent work. But I doubt you're gonna, I wouldn't want to finish the all at once. I'd want to have a stagger if possible for finishing them, and I could be working on five while finishing three. But I was hoping to do it where the first episode was fucking horrible, like, or not horrible, ridiculously simplistic.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I drew it where my skills were pathetic.
Mm-hmm.
But then, you know, within a month, if I was drawing a lot, because I could talk and draw at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
It's not, you know. Probably be good for me, you know, to distract and start not thinking about shapes and creating them from.
Right.
And then, like, the second episode would have the same characters, but they would have evolved and it looked better. Now, it's harder, because it's harder to get people to like shit, but if you get them into it and then they see their characters growing, you know, maybe there's not even color until. Maybe it starts to color in, you know, like maybe the main character gets colored in. I feel like he's good enough, then he becomes color. And then I could actually do Black Shadow as a comic book, where in the first episode, like, only the main character and whoever he was talking to would be drawn and colored. And all of the other ones would be, like, Pokemon characters you haven't seen yet. They'd just be outlined. You wouldn't even, you draw their shape, but you just color it in black. You actually have, like, my nephew would color in the lines in every single, so most of it would just be silhouettes and silhouettes and trees and buildings, all black, until we get to it, and then we fill it in. So you could do like Buffalo, with every, like, you'd recognize the shape of this in a frame, but, and then maybe even, I don't know, I guess once you take a picture of the frame, once you digitize it, you can go back very easily and update even old episodes. I always like that, because, like, if we were talking, me and you, even though you're not super, I want to be on camera, little boy. I just broke my train of thought with that. There's too many words and making fun of you. In a row.
Uh-huh.
I should have broken it up.
Uh-huh.
You having kids one day?
Yeah.
Two?
I don't know. That'd be kind of fun.
If you have to have all boys or all girls?
I don't really care.
Wonder how I was thinking about, like, dads who... who, like, don't have, like, they really want one boy, they don't, and they have, like, six fucking girls, and they don't, like, dislike the girls, but, like, fuck, I guess. They think about it, like, I don't have a son, can't do boy things.
What a boy.
Is there anything inherent about pink that attaches to women?
Yeah.
No wavelength? Is it possible that women have a slightly different eye chemistry, or something about being a mother could cause a wavelength? Mix of red, blood, and snow. Oh!
I think that probably there is a historic reason for that separation of, like, pink and blue.
Blue does not seem male to me, but go on.
Yeah.
Pink seems like, blue just seems like you needed a counterpoint.
Right.
I think red for boys might be better than...
Right. Yeah, I don't know. But I'm sure there's a historic reason for it. that's probably really arbitrary. I'm sensitive to pink just because it's such a strong color. Like, it's such an aggressive color to me.
Is that pink?
Pink. No, it's red.
What?
It's red.
Don't fucking fool yourself. Completely fooling yourself. You have a boy and girl shirt on right now. You have pink and blue. You want to be a boy?
Yeah.
Who's the cutest girl in the world?
Like, little girl?
Are you like 1% lesbian?
What does that mean? Like, am I at all attracted to women?
Yeah.
2%?
I don't know what percentage.
You're not 50-50.
No. I like...
You like boys?
Yeah. I like...
You like men?
Yeah.
You like man boys?
Apparently.
I feel like you just put me and Justin are in the same category now. I don't like that part of it.
Of man children?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Human children?
What did that brag about?
Humanthropy.
Do I what?
I said humanthropy. I did get Abraham to start calling himself a humanimal. T.A. said I love it. Because she won't, like, punish him for it, she'll just punish me for it.
Right.
But he gets to enjoy it.
Right.
And fuck with her at the same time.
Yeah, I'm not really interested in having sex with women.
With who?
Women.
Girls? Just kissing them?
That would probably be okay. I've never done it. And I've never, like, really, really wanted to. But I wouldn't be... It doesn't, like, repulse me.
Right. Would you be repulsed if they shaved? What do you think about women who like shave?
Shave what?
Stuff.
Like
no, like... armpits. You don't
care. As long as it's thick. As long as, like, it's their place to do whatever they want. I think that women who do it because they feel like they have to. Like, I don't think it's that. But
weird. When we were in front of a referee today, and the kid's lawyer was like, I think that they would do really well with mediation. I think we should see a mediator. And gave all these reasons why. And then the judge was like, Miss, would you? And she's like, I feel like, Your Honor, or Miss, she's like, Alex just wants an audience. And she's like, it was not about, like would you like to do? She was like, no, he wants an audience. After even knowing that a mediator would be there, and the kid's lawyer, who's friendly with both of us, like, they would be there. So it's not like she thinks I can, like, I get called an idiot, like, dumb as fuck. But somehow I'm smart and eloquent enough that I'm going to trick a mediator and the kid's lawyer into listening to some ridiculous soliloquy. Like, they're going to just, I'm going to transfix them. And I'm like, you can't think both. You can't call me stupid and think that I'm so talented that I'm going to trick these motherfuckers with my words and they're listening to everything that I...
Well, an audience isn't the same thing as tricking them, like...
No, but are they just going to listen? Are they going to listen to me just talk?
Because it's their job, yeah.
Not for the whole time. Not to just say anything I want, like, take over the whole thing. She's like, I'm going to take it over. I'm going to dominate because of some... Apparently because I want an audience, right? It seemed very incongruent with the truth that I like to talk to people, but... think that in that environment I'm gonna try to dominate and, like, be a dick and get away with it. Like, that's what she kind of believes. Like, I'm gonna get away with being a tricky dick. I'm like, I'm not. They're not gonna let me. Like, I wouldn't try. Like, I want to get along. You know, I want to cooperate. I want our kids to have better lives. I'm not trying to. This is not the audience I want. I can't record it anyways, which I'm used to doing. Like, it makes me comfortable. So I don't know. It's kind of. Finally agreed to say yes, though.
Okay.
And then she kind of almost cried. She's like, after we were about to run, she's like, we're gonna basically go to trial, or go, like, meet with police and lawyers. And she's like, she asked her a question. She's like, fine, I'll do mediation. She's like, I don't want to make you think that you're poor. She was like crying.
She said, I don't want to make you think what?
Like, that you have to do mediation. They're not gonna force you. But I think even, like, legally, she had to make sure, like, this is not a mandate.
Right.
She's saying they're not gonna, like,
penalize you, but I think they will. I think if a judge reads like she will not do mediation, it doesn't. You can say that, like, you know, you can. What are they doing? Like going over new possible rules? I mean, what,
yeah, this specific meeting, they're going to be talking about a lot of things, but on the agenda, among the things on the agenda is changing their gender policy.
What, so you can cut your hair like that?
Yeah.
When did you cut your hair? I don't remember the last time.
May 27th.
Oh, just that recently? Completely happy about it?
What?
Completely happy about it? It looks like fun.
Yeah, it's a lot more comfortable. I don't think about my hair like ever. So, and that's really different from when your hair is long. You always have to think about it because you put it up and you take it down and you go up again and you take it down. Whatever. I think those dragonflies are having sex.
Yeah, it did look like a double. Like an 8-foot high club. Not like in the one story club. It's fucking crazy, like they're flying and fucking. That's got, like, you don't have to do anything, right? I mean, you think just the minute differences in your movement would cause quite a bit of friction.
Right.
You know about the dragonfly effect? Should that be a cartoon?
What's that?
I don't know, it's like, it's...
Think a butterfly
effect? Yeah, but it's worse. I think, like, just what about Pixar? Like, Pixar does a lot of stuff in-house, but I have a feeling that with their ability, and even the people who made Utopia, like, those abilities, if you were to bring them a cohesive enough but concise enough idea for a story, they might just bring you in, be like, alright, we want to do this in-house, like, we'll hire you now, work with the team, like, we'll probably take a lot of this because we gotta make it our own, too. They can do like anything. The creatures, I mean, you know what? I think going hyper realistic is, you know, heard of the uncanny valley. Like, that can be a problem from what I've heard, and I believe it. But, like, when it comes to background, like, for me, like, a lot of my things are ideas, you know, like cities and mudslides and shareboards, like, that stuff, like, actually, like, designing it can happen very quickly. A lot of the stuff involves multiples, you know, like you create one refugee greenhouse, you're basically creating all of them, you know, you click multiply by 5,000, space them geometrically, throw them in the ocean, run the wave algorithm and watch the bob, you know, and watch the sun bounce, the fake sun bounce off of all of them, or put those same million greenhouses and just sit them down in the fucking Sahara Desert. And then the other wave algorithms, when we like break the dam and all the water rushes in from the ocean, the global sea levels go down this much, and then we tell the UN, like, we just showed you we can lower them an inch. It's now $50 billion an inch. And we can do that for a couple of years. That's one of the... But is that... Then we got to figure out, if we're doing this, like, how... Maybe I just have to, as I start to sketch, I got to...
Yeah, I heard that too. It wasn't a frog, I don't know what it was.
It was my chair. There were two weird fucking sounds this morning.
Yeah.
Like electronics, I'm like, oop! But electronic, oop! Twice. I don't know what the fuck they were.
Hmm.
Maybe something on my phone. My phone had never made those sounds before. You kind of set it up so you have like whatever frame one might be. I mean, maybe frame one, to me is like actually a poster. You know, like a really flowing, arty movie poster, you know, with a, maybe one central, like maybe Socrates the Cockatoo, I don't know what the fuck would be at the middle, like penetrating. Somebody could definitely hack your computer very easily to make it make sounds. I don't know, like, how close here and how long ago did the last two frogs fuck? Because I feel like it's not that far.
Yeah.
Or that long. I also don't feel like there's huge frog concentrations like in the city. So maybe the first one, and then I'm thinking like, when I think of it, I'm always like, to do this and feel okay about it, and to feel a sufficient degree of liberation, I need to have branches available, you know. I need to not follow one storyline exclusively, or even if I do, it may be like this, you know. It may, to get to the end of the story, it may look very meandering, and it may be obvious that there are short, you know, like there are other ways to do it. And I want to do it, and I mean, maybe if I start trying to sketch and get my sketch muscles developed, and then work with like somewhere between like a mind mapping program, or work with maybe some like, what's it called? Blender, and use like the 2D aspects of 3D design to kind of go into an open XYZ space and throw that poster in the middle and say, instead of just, I can go like a dice and go forward, back, up, right, left, or I mean, or anywhere in between, and then just really start out from the beginning, loosely designing it as a choose your own adventure in 3D, you know. It's not just a tree, or it's not a tree plus roots, you know, it's space. Like, you know, you have Minecraft, I really like the idea of mind space. And then, of course, then again, you need like some programming genius, because at some point you start to get these branches and you realize, I mean, it might not be hard to, if you tag everything, to have a basic level understanding of connections. Like, anything that has the tag of sphere is in one way going to have a line, but there's so much, like, I guess it's not that important. You don't have to fully understand. You could have this series of tales starting from a central premise that were very different, came from the same place, and didn't have to be immediately relatable, like, oh, I know how this relates to this exactly. Like, they don't. It gets a little weird. You have like this one goes, you have like this 36 point comic over here, and then like a 28 over here. And you realize it's possible that three of the actual frames in this one can be pulled. You know, you should just be able to pull out a frame, right? Sure. You want to make your own comic. You look at the basic comic, and you're like, I'm not. Or you'll be like, it's going to be another week before this is even finished. Or it could kind of be like, all right, I go through, I get to the end of the story, it may only be like 9 frames. You're like, you're into it, though. 9 frames could be enough, or 9 pages of this could be enough to get you really wanting to know more about a story. And then maybe you get to the end, and then you have to decide, or at least kind of cast the vote before the next frame is even created, like, which way do we go? And maybe in the beginning, the artist goes with the most popular. I mean, there's a lot of options moving forward. There'd be years of potential work to flesh things out, but then maybe there'd be some kind of a reward system where if you actually voted for the one that gets drawn, maybe you get it free or something, or there's some benefit to picking the right one. I was thinking if you didn't pick it, maybe you don't even get to see. But somebody screenshots that, and you can't keep shit secret. You can't say, oh, you're the only one who sees this. You can't do it. There's nothing that can be displayed on a phone that you can't videotape off the phone at work, or screenshot. I mean, screenshots can be, no, you can screenshot. I mean, Snapchat can tell when you screenshot, but it can't stop you from doing it. Like, there are no secrets. The other way is, I guess maybe you could get people to, like, promise. You'd be like, you sign the terms of service. Like, it's quite simple. You, It is completely against terms of service to screenshot or to share. You can ruin this. You can ruin this frame this week. But you'll never participate. And we talked about something like this, you'll never participate again. You can sneak and watch it in the future if someone else ruins it, but in order to interact, you have to deal with real eyes. You have to let the camera look at your eyes and know that it's you if you want to vote, if you want anything. You can just, if you want to be an insider, don't fuck us. Don't leak this, because it destroys it. It might be 4,000 years before you got rid of everyone who was a leaker, though. It takes just one person to leak something, and you ruin your ability to surprise people or, make them wait a little bit. Aquatic squeaking?
It's very cute.
Squeak-quatic. I hate when people do that.
What?
Make up words.
Really?
Well, usually they're not as, I'm going to say as good. They're not as practiced, and they're less confident. I don't give a fuck, really. A little bit, but not really. I know that I'm going to say stupid things. I accepted it a long time ago. It increases the odds of saying good things drastically.
Fear. The same goes for doing things.
Yeah. Nike was right, right? Talking the other day with this guy Don, we really came to the conclusion that it really does take a village. No, we actually came to the conclusion that it takes a village. A village. I already thought that several times. Give me a thumbs up. He's like a volunteer who got called off stage from an afternoon Wednesday Blue Man Group presentation. I have so much respect for his ability to play that part, as well as he fucking did. You almost want to think that's fucking him, that deep down inside of David Cross. David. Such a good job.
It's funny because he plays like a really earnest, kind of innocent guy, and you're so cynical and so...
Did you see his last comedy special?
No, you told me
about it. Oh, the aversions? I have an aversion to that. I am a version of myself. I think I've actually officially lost track. I cannot make a list of all the women that I've been with. It's only 22. I'll make a list right now. Who the fuck was the last one? Oh. Sexist or anything, or is this sex-ass?
No.
Elizabeth, Nicole, oh god. Dia, Anne. Ooh, this is not gonna be good. Who was the first? Kelly. Her friend, what was her friend's name? Julie. I've never.
Sorry, I tried to write Costco and it, for some reason, C9 said serum. And so I just almost asked my housemate if he wanted to make some serum with me tonight.
pasta? 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 I can't do this. I can't. I'll never, ever finish this. Randy. No, this is not good. Oh god, my memory is fucking shot. Start naming names. Name names.
Amber, Amy.
Amy.
Anna Lee. Really?
Yeah. Amy Miller. I think that other girl's name was Anna too. Is she on it? No, Anna. Ann Labrador, Anna. I'm like, where did I live when
Andrea.
I went? There might be like more.
Alexandra.
Yeah, let's go by races.
You always do?
No, I was trying to like any way to break it down. It only counts if you actually have intercourse, right? Because there was this black Jewish dancer from Manhattan that we used to take showers together and well, we didn't actually.
You just
yeah, she kind of like
you
had a. No, we touched each other. She kind of like, I was very close. Like, I let him go, like, kind of like, be behind her in the shower. She had like a really nice ass.
Mm-hmm. But there was no touching?
Oh, there was touching. But I'm talking like, I'm saying sex as it. Yes. I've only got like one, two, three. Some of the earlier ones are really hard.
That, Bethany, Betsy, Bertha.
It's probably the worst way to do it ever.
It worked for one of them.
It was some like Z girl or something. She lived right down the street. She was very. No, I just put Z in fine. Randy in Manhattan. Some of you guys can't remember.
Cassandra. Harley. Kara. Kara.
Baddest. Skinniest. Smartest.
How many you got right now?
There's some I can picture, but I can't remember their fucking names.
Well, describe the situation in which you met them.
Oh, there's one I met at Aroma. I think she had a breast reduction. I don't even know the fuck she had. I have to move something. And she went, Angie. Tia calls her Maggie. She was kind of like a little diesel and had. I don't think I did. This is so stupid. That's 16. Now 23. Wait, Tia, Melissa, Nina, 23. I wanted to stop at 20. It's a good number.
20 was Tia?
Oh, there were a couple girls from the internet. Oh, Griffith, what the hell is it? Cheryl. How does this, I can't justify this as part of an episode.
What?
I don't know. What did you say you
it's
need?
It's honoring everyone you've ever had sex with.
Tia's the
it's
only
a remembrance.
Tia's the only one I really did a really good job with. I need to be comfortable. what was your price, did you say? Not, we're not talking about sex anymore. I didn't mean it at all. I was moving on.
For shaving my head?
No, no, no. So, like, to be a priest for democracy.
What? I didn't name a price, and I don't even really know what you mean.
Just help.
What?
Just help. You can even continue if you want.
But I am helping.
You are doing a lot. You do, like, 4 hours a week. That's like a tenth of a full work week.
Okay.
It's pretty good. Impressive.
What does it mean when someone says, I don't have the spoons to do that?
The what?
The spoons to do that.
It's probably an autocorrect. Did it make pasta?
No, to go to the board meeting. Or the, sorry, the school board meeting.
Spoons.
Whoa, that was probably so fun for that ant. I went like this, and it kind of like spun around like this and then fell on the ground.
Is it as big as it looks, or is it carrying something?
Oh, no, it's big as it looks.
It's crazy that the size is different. There must be different species. There was a baby on my counter. It was fucking small. It's like a millimeter.
Ants rule the world, or could, if they wanted to. They outnumber us like 1,000,000,000 to 1 or something like that.
Well, then bacteria could rule the world.
But ants, like, they have colonies that span continents.
Yeah, but how long do you think it would take for you wearing electrified snowshoes to kill 1,000,000,000 ants? If we really went to war, it wouldn't even be a good fight.
I don't think we would be able to kill all of them.
Yeah, but would they be able to kill all of us?
Yeah.
How? Choke us to death?
No, like, if you get swarmed by a bunch of ants and they're the biting kind or the poisonous kind.
Which are not, which are like 1 in 1,000. So they only outnumber us 1,000,000 to 1. You're saying if they came after us, if they could find us, break up, divide the labor and come after us, I mean, they could choke you to death.
Just by, like, crawling into your throat?
Like, they distract you with your ears and your eyes, yeah, and, like, hundreds of, they form, like, a ball, and they roll into your mouth, and then they'd, like...
this is a really bad movie. I...
You don't want to talk about it anymore?
Really upsetting.
Sometimes I wonder, like, what percentage of dogs could beat what percentage of monkeys? And, like, what about all the dogs in the world versus all the cats? Like, there's not that many tigers, there's a lot.
They made a movie about that.
Dogs versus cats? What if you, see, I don't like hair. I want to get all my hair completely removed. I just want to, like, be dunked into a tank. Can I do that?
You can get electrolysis and or laser hair removal.
You can't just dip yourself in, like, epi stuff or whatever it's called? Or...
Nair?
Yeah.
You could. Probably wouldn't feel very good.
How many people are, like, rich enough that they go to sleep at night and then have people work on them? Like, they're basically in a room where the atmosphere has a bit of a... chemical to help keep them under very low. Like they have to fall asleep, but it'll help. Then they increase it a little bit, and then they just get the teeth done, get shaved, probably even like jerked off in their sleep. Just wake up feeling like really good.
Yeah, interesting. I don't know if anyone's done that, but it seems like something that would take to do.
Like in terms of not making episodes, but what do I have to do between like now and next week? Work, like work-wise, what am I supposed to actually get done? I started the company, that's a joke. I have like 80 days left to write an operations agreement, which you can amend it, but like what is the company? What other shit, like what kind of stock is there? What does it take to get one? How, like, there's a lot of defaults in the corporate code, like the LLC code, for like, if you don't write it down, this is how it defaults to being. A lot of times it's like, if 50% of the members vote for this, and this. Oh yeah. Venture capital? Venture capital!
No, not that idea, just writing your ideas down on t-shirts and selling them.
I can't, the label can't be venture capital?
Oh no, it can, but it won't be a venture, whatever. The whole complicated thing
never comes. What if we can invest complicated?
No, I mean, you could just get regular t-shirts and print things that you, like your ideas on it, and just sell them.
With the built-in?
Really, really simple at first.
With a built-in clothes hanger hanging off the back?
No.
That would be kind of cool though.
What do you mean?
I don't know.
Exactly. So don't do that yet.
What about?
Don't write that into
it. What about hangers?
So you're going to start as a t-shirt?
Aw, hey baby. Mm-hmm. It's so sweet, like when there's just one.
Oh, I just dove down and ate something.
I'm sure there are. There's obviously life in here. Everything in the world that's green is alive. Unless it's been painted.
It's like doing its own
thing. What do you think it's getting?
Oh no.
Actually, there's these little. Oh, this is fungus that fell off my foot. Oh, there's stuff in there. There's bugs underwater.
Yeah?
Yeah. Oh. That's weird. It's like an insect that's down there. For it doesn't look like it has to. What the hell is it looking for?
Algae.
I wonder how many of these are like, my motherfucking parents had to have me in this fucking puddle. Hey, it is pretty violent. Sometimes he, oh wow, that was crazy. He like, looks like he's gonna chill, and he turned like 120 degrees to the right and dove like instantly. I don't know how the fuck he even. Looks like he's like, someone, there's a magnet pulling him along underwater.
Yeah.
Bumper ducks would be cool. They have that giant duck, right? If you're outside,
yeah.
There's like a giant fucking.
What is that happen? Sunday?
I invented something, what was it called? It was an autonomous, inflatable autonomous emergency fishing duck. It was like a little briefcase. And there was a really squeezed up like rubber duck. And it would inflate and its back had solar panels and it had like a little spool of fishing line and a hook, and it could like just send it out and just swims around and lowers the string down until it fucking, it's like a bobber. It stores up enough energy in a capacitor so that if it gets a bite, it like yanks. And as it catches the fish, it just kind of like gets pulled on until the fish gets exhausted and it brings it back to you.
Why would it go pull along until the fish gets exhausted? That's torture. Why would it do that?
No, well, because the fish is strong. Fishermen wait for fish to tire out a little bit. I mean, you don't, a lot of times you do it and you wait a little, you don't want to pull out a super hyper fish if possible, I think.
That's
okay, so we'll send electricity down the line and shock it to death. What if he's just like self-conscious and is pretending to eat so it makes him feel guilty for chilling? That's actually almost big enough, certainly for what he's doing now, but I think robotic technology with a battery life of only 5 minutes is almost enough to build him.
Enough to what?
To build a seagull, like a drone seagull. A floating one would be a joke, but the flying is still very... I keep thinking the tip of his bill is what he's eating. Look at
that. I know, that's what I thought too.
There are probably thousands.
Do you think the calories or any bugs that it's eating
worth enough to pay for it?
To like dive that violently?
Mm-hmm. I don't think he'd be here if it wasn't the case. Why are there no others though? That's the weird thing. Like, is he like, ooh, I'm gonna go off the beaten path and get bigger than my other thing? He's like, oh shit, I'm starving. He never goes back, the prodigal seagull.
Prodigal.
Prodigal. So you did it.
No, you did it. You just didn't.
I didn't say right, but you have to realize it. Otherwise, every person who said momentum would already have did it. Oftentimes when I see statues, I want them to be far away, and I want to shoot, on a windy day, I want to shoot a dodgeball cannon and try to hit them from like 500 meters away.
Are you going to get a dodgeball?
Well, no, this is shooting them from a cannon, but I'm good at dodging. I always wanted to shoot at like statues of historically evil figures. Mm-hmm.
There's
like
one
a,
of Christopher Columbus in there.
What about King Leopold?
No.
You know about him?
No, not as much.
Apparently he killed about 10 million people in Africa. Belgium, I think, he was a king and he like took the Congo and just killed mad people down there. It was like his personal slave state. Apparently he definitely exceeded Hitler. You probably don't care though, because you're not Congolese. You ever heard of Congolese of rice?
That is made.
It is not.
No?
I'm calling bullshit.
Okay.
Go on. You can still do it, but.
It's made by putting human feces into a bottle and then leaving it in the sun to ferment for a week with a balloon on top of it so it catches the gas, and then you huff the gas and it's hallucinogenic.
Yeah. Oh,
good.
Didn't Seagull eat it? This would be a cool roach. Do they make roaches, right? Like an actual roach.
That you can smoke. Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Why is his leg? His legs were inside there too?
Yeah, isn't that crazy?
It's like maybe that's where we learned molding from. Isn't it cool? Molting and molding?
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if that's what it's named after. It seems like it could be.
Maybe.
Like, if it is a pretty exact mold.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what the etymology of that.
How many seagulls have ever been roofied?
Three.
Seagulls?
Yeah.
Oh, hi out there.
Yeah.
You play tennis?
No.
You're fucking draining out like